Canst thou forget that sad, that solemn day when victims at yon altar's foot we lay? Canst thou forget what tears that moment fell when, warm in youth, I bade the word for farewell? As with cold lips I kissed the sacred veil, the shrines all trembled and the lamps grew pale. Heaven scarce believed the conquest it surveyed, and saints with wonder heard the vows I made. Yet then, to those dread altars as I drew, not on the cross my eyes were fixed, but you. Not grace or zeal, love only was my call, and if I lose thy love, I lose my all. Come, with thy looks, thy words relieve my woe, thou still at least art left thee to bestow. Still on that breast enamored let me lie, still drink delicious poison from thy eye. Pant on thy lip, and to thy heart be pressed, give all thou canst, and let me dream the rest. Ah, no. Instruct me other joys to prize, with other beauties charm my partial eyes. Full in my view set all the bright abode, and make my soul quit Abelard for God. Ah, think at least thy flock deserves thy care, plants of thy hand and children of thy prayer. From the false world in early youth they fled, by thee to mountains, wilds, and deserts led. You raised these hallowed walls, the desert smiled, and paradise was opened in the wild. No weeping orphan saw his father's stores, our shrines irradiate or emblaze the floors. No silver saints, by dying misers given, here bribed the rage of ill-requited heaven. But such plain roofs as piety could raise, and only vocal with the master's maker's praise. In these lone walls, their days eternal bound, these moss-grown domes with spiry turrets crowned, where awful arches made a noonday sun, and the dim windows shed a solemn light, the eyes diffused a reconciling ray, and gleams of glory brightened all the day. But now no face divine contentment wears, 'tis all blank sadness or continual tears. See how the force of others' prayers I try, O pious fraud of amorous charity. But why should I on others' prayers depend? Come thou, my father, brother, husband, friend. Ah, let thy handmaid, sister, daughter move, and all those tender names in one thy love. The darksome pines that o'er yon rocks reclined wave high and murmur to the hollow wind. The wandering streams that shine between the hills, the grots that echo to the tinkling rills, the dying gales that pant upon the trees, the lakes that quiver to the curling breeze. No more these scenes my meditation aid, or lull to rest the visionary maid, but o'er the twilight groves and dusky caves, long-sounding aisles and intermingled graves. Black melancholy sits, and round her throws a death-like silence and a dread repose. Her gloomy presence saddens all the scene, shades every flower and darkens every green, deepens the murmur of the falling floods, and breathes a browner horror on the woods. Yet here, forever, ever must I stay, sad proof how well a lover can obey. Death, only death can break the lasting chain, and here, even then, shall my cold dust remain. Here all its frailties, all its flames resign, and wait till 'tis no sin to mix with thine. Ah, wretch! Believe the spouse of God in vain, confessed within the slave of love and man. Assist me, heaven! But whence arose that prayer? Sprung it from piety or from despair? Even here, where frozen chastity retires, love finds an altar for forbidden fires. I ought to grieve, but cannot what I ought. I mourn the lover, nor lament the fault. I view my crime, but kindle at the view, repent old pleasures and solicit new. Now turn to heaven, I weep my past offense. Now think of thee, and curse my innocence. Of all affliction taught a lover yet, 'tis sure the hardest science to forget. How shall I lose the sin, yet keep the sense, and love the offender, yet detest the offense? How the dear object from crime remove, or how diminish penitence from love? Unequal task, a passion to resign, for hearts so touched, so pierced, so lost as mine. Ere such a soul regains its peaceful state, how often must it love, how often hate? How often hope, despair, resent, regret, conceal, disdain, do all things but forget? But let heaven seize it, all at once 'tis fired, not touched but rapt, not wakened but inspired. O come, O teach me nature to subdue, renounce my love, my life, myself, and you. Fill my fond heart with God alone, for he alone can rival, can succeed to thee. How happy is the blameless vestal's lot, the world forgetting by the world forgot. Eternal sunshine of a spotless mind, each prayer accepted and each wish resigned. Labor and rest that equal periods keep, obedient slumbers that can wake and weep. Desires composed, affections ever even, tears that delight and sighs that waft to heaven. Grace shines around her with serenest beams, and whispering angels prompt her golden dreams. For her the unfading rose of Eden blooms, and wings of seraphs shed divine perfumes. For her the spouse prepares the bridal ring, for her white virgins hymeneals sing. To sound of heavenly harps she dies away, and melts in visions of eternal day. Far other dreams my erring soul employ, far other raptures or unholy joy. When at the close of each sad sorrowing day, fancy restores what vengeance snatched away, then conscience sleeps, and leaving nature free, all my loose soul unbounded springs to thee. O cursed, dear horrors of all conscious night, how glowing guilt exalts the keen delight. Provoking demons all restraint remove, and stir within me every source of love. I hear thee, view thee, gaze o'er all thy charms, and round thy phantom glue my clasping arms. I wake. No more I hear, no more I view, the phantom flies me as unkind as you. I call aloud, it hears not what I say, I stretch my empty arms, it glides away. To dream once more I close my willing eyes, ye soft illusions, dear deceits, arise. Alas, no more. Methinks we wandering go through dreary wastes and weep each other's woe. Where round some mouldering tower pale ivy creeps and low-browed rocks hang nodding o'er the deeps. Sudden you mount, you beckon from the skies, clouds interpose, waves roar and winds arise. I shriek, start up, the same sad prospect find, and wake to all the griefs I left behind. For thee, the fates, severely kind, ordain a cool suspense from pleasure and from pain. Thy life, a long dead calm, a fixed repose, no pulse that riots, and no blood that glows, still as the sea ere winds were taught to blow, or moving spirit bade the waters flow. Soft as the slumber of a saint forgiven, and mild as opening gleams of promised heaven. Come, Abelard, for what hast thou to dread? The torch of Venus burns not for the dead. Nature stands checked, religion disapproves. Even thou art cold, yet Eloisa loves. Ah, hopeless, lasting flames, like those that burn to light the dead and warm the unfruitful urn. What scenes appear where'er I turn my view, the dear ideas where I fly pursue, rise in the grove before the altar rise, stain all my soul and wanton in my eyes. I waste the matin lamp and sighs for thee, thy image steals between my God and me. Thy voice I seem in every hymn to hear, with every bead I drop too soft a tear. When from the censer clouds of fragrance roll, and swelling organs lift the rising soul, one thought of thee puts all the pomp to flight. Priests, tapers, temples swim before my sight. In seas of flame, my plunging soul is drowned, while altars blaze and angels tremble round. While prostrate here in humble grief I lie, kind, virtuous drops just gathering in my eye, while praying, trembling in the dust I roll, and dawning grace is opening on my soul. Come, if thou darest, all charming as thou art, oppose thyself to heaven, dispute my heart. Come with one glance of those deluding eyes, blot out each bright idea of the skies. Take back that grace, those sorrows and those tears, take back my fruitless penitence and prayers. snatch me just mounting from the blessed abode, assist the fiends, and tear me from my God. No, fly me far as pole from pole, rise Alps between us, and whole oceans roll. O come not, write not, think not once of me, nor share one pang of awe I felt for thee. Thy oaths I quit, thy memory resign, forget, renounce me, hate whate'er was mine. Fair eyes and tempting looks, which yet I view, long loved, adored ideas, all adieu. O grace serene, O virtue heavenly fair, divine oblivion of low-thoughted care, fresh blooming hope, gay daughter of the sky, and faith, our early immortality. Enter each mild, each amicable guest, receive and wrap me in eternal rest. See in her cell sad Eloisa spread, propped on some tomb, a neighbor of the dead. In each low wind, methinks a spirit calls, and more than echoes, talk along the walls. Here, as I watched the dying lamps around, from yonder shrine I heard a hollow sound. Come, sister, come, it said or seemed to say. Thy place is here, sad sister, come away. Once like thyself I trembled, wept, and prayed, love's victim then, though now a sainted maid. But all is calm in this eternal sleep. Here grief forgets to groan, and love to weep. Even superstition, love's every fear, for God, not man, absolves our frailty here. I come, prepare your roseate bowers, celestial palms, and ever-blooming flowers. Thither, where sinners may have rest, I go, where flames refined in breast's seraphic glow. Thou, Abelard, the last sad office pay, and smooth my passage to the realms of day. See my lips tremble and my eyeballs roll, suck my last breath and catch my flying soul. Ah, no, in sacred vestments mayst thou stand, the hallowed taper trembling in thy hand. Present the cross before my lifted eye, teach me at once and learn of me to die. But ah, then, thy once loved Eloisa see, it will be then no crime to gaze on me. See for my cheek the transient roses fly, see the last sparkle languish in my eye. Come every motion, pulse, and breath be o'er, and even my Abelard be loved no more. O death all eloquent, you only prove what dust we dote on, when 'tis man we love. Then too, when fate shall thy fair frame destroy, that cause of all my guilt and all my joy, in trance ecstatic may thy pangs be drowned, bright clouds descend, and angels watch thee round. From opening skies may streaming glory shine, and saints embrace thee with a love like mine. May one kind grave unite each hapless name, and graft my love immortal on thy fame. Then, ages hence, when all my voice woes are o'er, when this rebellious heart shall beat no more, if ever chance to wandering lovers bring, to Paraclete's white walls and silver springs, o'er the pale marble shall they join their heads, and drink the falling tears with other each other sheds, then sadly say, with mutual pity moved, oh, may we never love as these have loved. From the full choir when loud hosannas rise and swell the pomp of dreadful sacrifice, amid that scene, if some relenting eye glance on the stone where our cold relics lie, devotion's self shall steal a thought from heaven. One human tear shall drop and be forgiven, and sure if fate some future bard shall join in sad similitude or of griefs to mine, condemned whole years in absence to deplore, and image charms he must behold no more. Such, if there be, who loves so long so well, let him our sad, our tender story tell. The well-sung woes will soothe my pensive ghost. He best can paint them who shall feel them most.